What up, and welcome back to another Grill Master Mason video. I'm Mason, and this is my channel.
You work numbers, work wonders. You didn't woke me up from my eternal slumber. I'm the lightning.
Today we're going to be going over all of my cookware and everything I use, so it's going to be a long video, I think, so let's get into this. First, we have my cast iron pans. I have three of them. One's smaller, one's medium, one's big. And I got them for my birthday, for my grandma. And there's my cast iron. Second, I have all these tin pans with lids. I have probably 15 more in the cabinet. But they help with like pork butt or chuck roast. I'm gonna put liquid in there, and it really helps. Third is my vacuum sealer. I got it for Christmas. It's a vacuum sealer brand. And I have vacuum seal bags here. I just got it for Christmas, so I did it like one time, so. I have my spray bottle. Ace Hardware spray bottle. Don't work that great. But I use it to spritz mostly ribs and sometimes pork butt with all of my injection liquid. I just put it in there, spray it every hour. But that's my sprayer. I have these cinnamon sticks that I got to make my birria tacos. These are my oven mitt kind of things. I originally got them to hold my cast iron pans, but they kind of burnt when I tried to take something off the grill. They're still kind of nice, but I don't use them much anymore. These are the bear paws or meat claws, whatever you call them. Mostly used for like shredded pork butt, or even I help them to like cut when I'm cutting like brisket or something. I use it as like a fork. For some reason, I got these at Ace Hardware, but they're like falling apart, like shredding. I don't know. I don't recommend it. This is my meat thermometer that I got at Bed Bath & Beyond. It's the digital one, Salter. But yeah, this works pretty good. I lost my other one, so I bought a new one. So these are my measuring cups. I also got these at Bed Bath & Beyond. These say smidgen, pinch, dash, and tad. And then I have the teaspoon and the tablespoon. This is the 1/8 teaspoon, 1/4 teaspoon. 1/2 teaspoon, 1 teaspoon, and 1 tablespoon. They're pretty good. I like them, so I recommend them. And I have there's 1/4 cup, 1/3 cup, 1/2 cup, and 1 cup in here. And they're pretty good. This is my Inkbird Wi-Fi thermometer with the four probe one. So the Bluetooth. I got sent to me by, I forget her name, but Kyle Walker sent me this and the Killer Hogs seasoning package. So, thank you. I forget your name. I don't know how to say it either, but thank you so much. This is my only stainless steel mixing bowl. I forget how big it is. Wait, hold on. I don't know, but I kind of screwed it up, as you can see the scratches in there when I use an electric mixer. And I got this at Bed Bath & Beyond too, so. I have this scraper chopper. That's the OXO stainless steel one. I got this at Bed Bath & Beyond too. And this was the cutting board, first cutting board I got. I got it from the dollar store, actually. It's not bad, but the knives I got with it are not very good. But I recommend this. This is really good. I have these squeeze bottles I got at the dollar store too. I have like two of them. They're alright. Just put like oil in it or whatever. This is the garlic chopper from Pampered Chef. It was my mom's, but she gave it to me. It's the one. I can't really see it. But you go. And it's pretty good. But when you're chopping garlic, it gets stuck in the blade. But it comes apart easily, so you can clean it inside and out. These are my like heat gloves. I got them, you wear them under like rubber gloves when you're handling meat or something. They're pretty good. I got them, I think they're the Oklahoma Joe ones. And I got them at Lowe's, so. This is my burger press. It has, so if you take this gray part out, and then this is just to make regular burgers. When you put the gray part in, it'll click. And then you use the small side, and you can make sliders with it. This is the OXO meat tenderizer I got at Bed Bath & Beyond, too. And they got so many gift cards there, that's why I have so much stuff from there. But the stuff's pretty good, so I don't even use this yet. I might use it on my steak tonight, but I don't know. This is my meat injector I just got at the local grocery store. It's not very, it's okay, but it's not the best. When you put it in the meat that you're injecting with, when you push it out, it comes out of those holes, but it like comes out through the meat again. Like it doesn't stay in, but it's okay. I'm not complaining. This is the whisk I got for Christmas. It's from Pampered Chef. My aunt got it for me. And it's pretty nice. It's the stainless steel one. It's really heavy, though. Like, heavy duty. This is the baster, I think you call it, that my mom got me for Christmas. It's clear. I don't know what brand it is, but it's pretty nice. This is my other meat thermometer. It's from Good Cook. And it doesn't work that well. I bought it when I lost my digital thermometer. So I don't recommend this. I just got this from the local grocery store. This is a melon baller. I really have no idea why I bought this, but I have it. So it's from Good Cook as well. And I really haven't used it. I have no idea what to do with it, but I bought it, so. This is my spatula I got from Bed Bath & Beyond. I think it's the OXO kind. And it's pretty good. I used it to make burgers like 2 days ago. This is the Traeger pink butcher paper. It's kind of tall, so. But it's the Traeger. I don't recommend this. You can get it a lot cheaper at like Walmart. But I got this at Ace Hardware for like 30 bucks. I wouldn't get this brand. One, it's Traeger. And two, it's expensive, so. This is a Food Network baking pan. It can actually go on the smoker or your grill. I use it to make smoked queso, and it actually holds up really well, so. I only use it like twice. My grandma got me it. That's the Food Network. So. This is my cutting board, if you haven't seen it already. I got this at Bed Bath & Beyond. My grandpa got it for me for my birthday. I don't know the brand, but it has these silicone mats on the bottom, and it's stained. I don't know why, but it don't hurt, so it's pretty good. It's like, let's say, a foot by like 8 inches, so. I actually got this given to me by a friend of ours. It's a easy cooking with 5 ingredients, and it has like, that's all 5 ingredient recipes right there. I haven't used any yet because I don't know what to make out of it, but it's really neat for like a beginner like me. But it has like sausage balls, sausage pineapple bits. It has a whole bunch of stuff. Like there's punch in here. Yeah, it's pretty cool. This is a fast entrees book. I haven't really looked through it, so I'll have nothing to say about it, but I have it, so. These are the 3 Pampered Chef cutting mats that my aunt gave to me when I started cooking. And this one has like the cube, if you want to do cube something. This one has the different knives on it. And this one shows how to julienne, or I don't know how you say it, but yeah, it's on there. This was given to me by our neighbors across the street. It's the Coleman grilling set. This is the grill cleaner or grill brush. And this is the spatula with it has the spike sides there. And it also comes with the tongue, but that is around my grill and I do not feel like getting them, so. These are the dried chilies I used for the quesadilla I made. These are the chili casabel. These are the chili ancha chilies. These are the pasilla chilies. They're not all the right ones, but I really could not find them anywhere. These are my cast iron holders that I got. They're just fit over the handle. I got this one, but it like doesn't shut. That's all it is, like right there. These are my two-man knives. This is my, I think it's the J.A. Henkel's International. I don't know how you say it, but it's the Forge Elite German Stainless Steel. And this is my really good knife. My grandpa got it for me for my birthday with my cutting board. And it's my main knife. This is my Farberware cleaver knife. I just got it for Christmas, so I haven't really used it yet. It's not very sharp, but I'll get it there. Alright, I'm going to be doing like a couple items at a time, because I have a lot of stuff. These I got for Christmas. They're like kind of like my family calls them an oven glove. And I have two of them, but one's out on my grill. And like I said, I don't feel like going out there. These are the Northlander, just grilling mitts. They're like rubber, so I have two of them. And I have this. I use for clean my grill off. It's really clean, I don't know why. But that's what I use to clean my grill. This is my meat scale. It's an OXO. My uncle gave it to me. He said he used it like one time. It goes up to 11 pounds. You can use it for like burger patties or something. It's pretty good. I can see if you can. And it's digital. Put any weight on it. It goes up to 11 pounds. These are my salt and pepper shakers. I don't remember where I got them from. This is the black peppercorns, and it's pretty good. See, they look pretty good, but they kind of make a mess. So, all right. This is butcher's twine I never opened, and these are all of my meat probes, but there's one that's not in there. I have five of them, because four came with the ink bird, and one came with my grill. So I keep them in the coffee can. These are my wooden utensils. I have the spatula, the spoon, two spoons, and this is the fork that I have. I have like 10 of them, and there's nothing to say about them. Okay, then all I have left is, as you can see, I have everything on the table and the stuff I just did over there. But these are all of my seasonings. I have all the Killer Hogs rub that I got sent to me. The Texas brisket rub, the 8-piece seasoning, a hot barbecue rub. Sorry, my camera skills are bad. Give me a minute here. This is the steak rub from Killer Hogs. I have some Old Bay. I have some celery salt. I have, my uncle got me this for Christmas, the Tres Diablos Loquia Scorpion and Habanero Hot Sauce from Pepper Palace. I have lemon pepper. I have two of these wing sauces. One's garlic and one's mild. I have honey chipotle rum barbecue sauce. Never tried it. Can't wait to. These are my bay leaves. I have KC butt spice for pork, beef, and poultry. I have this kicking chicken that my uncle got me in love with. Stuff is so good, but it's spicy, so you have to like spicy stuff. I have some Traeger beef rub. I don't like Traeger, so I don't have much of Traeger stuff. But I have this. I have tahine. I think that's how you say it. I have rub sage. I have my own salt pepper rub that I made for my brisket. put a lot of salt in there, as you can see, because it's salt and pepper. This is my rosemary flakes, or whatever you call it, from Pepper Creek Farms. I think I got it from TJ Maxx, yeah. TJ Maxx. I have this black rose hot sauce from Pepper Palace. It has, well, I gotta read it. It has distilled vinegar, red jalapeno, cayenne, habanero, garlic, sugar, salt, ginger, red pepper, black pepper, xanthan gum. That one is very good. It's a very mild rub. This is the Stubbs pork rub with sea salt, garlic, and lime. I have whole cloves I got to make my birria. I don't know why I used them, but I saw them in one video, so I got them. I just have some black pepper. My homemade beef rub, or barbecue rub. I don't remember what's in it, but I do have a notepad here. It's paprika, salt, onion powder, garlic powder. That's all I put in it because I had no idea what I was doing. I have some, this is the adobo I use. I know some people use the other adobo. This is the only one I can find around here. I have some Mott's Tots apple juice that I use to spritz my pork butt and my ribs. No, here's one more Killer Hogs rub. This is the barbecue rub. This is my favorite one. We use it so many times on baby back ribs. This is so good. I recommend this a lot. I love, I don't remember his name. How to Barbecue Right. Yes, I love him. And last couple things, I have some apple cider vinegar. I have some ground coriander I used for my birria. Some honey. And that's about it. I think I showed these cinnamon sticks I used for my birria. And I also have, under all of that stuff, I have a black grill mat. And I have no idea how to use them. So those are my spices, and that's all my cookie stuff. I also have these. I have a food dehydrator and a KitchenAid food processor that I got for Christmas. The air fryer, it's not mine, but we have it. Those are all our spices. There's our stove and our stuff. Our house is a mess, but that's all my stuff. Thank you guys for watching, and hopefully that wasn't too long of a video. And I do film on my phone, so, but I'm not complaining. Camera quality's good. But that's all of my stuff, pretty much all of it. There's some on the island there, and on top of the fridge, like I said. But yeah, that's about it, and thanks for watching, and outro, classic man.